Around 4 months old, Justin started having periods of time where he stopped breathing. His lips would turn blue and he'd kind of get a little gray.
When Justin was just a few months old, he came in with seizures and what turned out to be a tumor that was right in this area, which I took out when he was an infant. He's done very well with that, but in the past year or so, it started to have a lot of seizures that have not been responding well to medications.
He would be on a medicine for a while, it would seem to be working, and then he'd start having seizures again. The neurologist said that usually after 3 or 4 medicines, when you fail, that's when they start talking about other options, and one of them would be surgery. Dr. Madsen actually gave us 2 options when we met with him. The first was a craniotomy with Justin awake. And I said, isn't there anything else that we can do? I don't want to open up his head again. And he said, well, you know, actually there is something new that's being done and I think it might work.
This procedure we'll do today, we don't actually open up and see the brain at all directly with our eyes. We will pass a probe into this area from back here, kind of along the axis. Once we get the coordinates of where we want the tip of our laser to be, the head frame with those big wings and sliders that you see will be what actually directs our passage of the laser right into this lesion. We will ablate it by heating it up. There's a diode laser that will heat the tissue up in a very specific place, so that the cells die in an area that we can prescribe. There's really 2 critically important advances in technology which have allowed this kind of therapy to be done. One is the ability to use MRI studies to very precisely plan and direct our treatment. And we have the advantage here of being actually in an MRI scanner room, which is also an operating room. The other technology is the ability to use the MRI signal to detect temperature in the brain. And this was a very important discovery that has made it possible to safely, literally, turn on a laser inside the human brain.
Okay, laser's on.
Okay, if you watch this one now, we'll set some yellow.
A centimeter and a half.
This is the new damage, and this is the current temperature. In this picture, you can see that there's 3 epicenters, 1, 2, 3, which is the shape that we wanted to get. I'm very happy with this, and I would say he has an 80 to 90% chance of having his seizures controlled now.
Justin's recovery was amazing. We were discharged at noon the day after surgery, and by the time we got home, Justin already wanted to go down the road and play and be out and doing things. And I think the hardest part of the recovery for me was holding him back a little bit because, you know, he feels fine. 3 weeks post-surgery now and he has not had any seizures since we've been home. I knew we made the right choice.